Are we live? I hope we're live. We're live. All right. Hey, everybody. This is Elise and Hallie.
Hello.
And I'm so glad you're here. If you are watching us today, if you want to comment, there's a little message that says, if you want to comment, you have to allow StreamYard to access your Facebook profile. And you just click a little button there. Otherwise, I can see you, we can see you in the comment section, but I can't tell who you are. All it says is a Facebook member. So if you want to be known, if you'd like me to know who you are, either do that connection thing or put your name in your comment so we can see who you are. So let's get started. It is noon, so we'll get started. I am Elise Tager. What am I, Hallie? I am a business coach for ambitious female entrepreneurs and the creator of the Solo2CEO program. Mm-hmm. I am here to have a chat with Hallie Agostinelli.
Did I pronounce it? If you say it like this with your hand, it helps. Agostinelli.
Agostinelli. It's very Italian. Okay, that's great. Anyway, I'm delighted that you're here today. We're going to be talking about virtual assistants to the rescue and what a virtual assistant is all about. Mm-hmm. If you're here and you're watching me, drop something in the comments so I can say hi and know that you're there. Put your name in so we can see who's there. I can see there are three people watching. So hello, whoever you are. Facebook user says, hi, I'm excited for this event. Let me know who you are, you guys, so we aren't just talking to this blank Facebook screen. So sorry, that's just one of the problems with StreamYard. So Hallie's with me today. You guys know Hallie. Hallie is our community concierge, and she's been with us for a while. She is the woman who, first of all, she's the goddess, and she takes very good care of all of us. And so she greets you when you come in. She'll have conversations with you in the DM. She's doing a lot of interaction in the group. I just love that she's with us. And I couldn't think of anybody else better to give us a view on the whole virtual assistant thing. So Hallie, I'm so glad you're here.
I'm so glad to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, good. So let me just introduce you. You gave me a bio. So, hey, Ayana, I'm so glad you're here. Good, good. So Hallie has over 30 years of experience in multifaceted industries, including large corporations like Marriott Hotels and Wells Fargo Mortgage and BNI. She also has a solopreneur side to her. You are a solopreneur, yes. Mm-hmm. She owned her own professional organizing company and now owns her own VA business called Virtual Matters. Mm-hmm. I didn't know you were an organizer. God, I'm so glad you can't see my desk. She comes to us with a love of social media, spreadsheets, and operations. I think this is how Hallie and I bonded, is mm-hmm. that I am just a spreadsheet junkie, as is she. And we were both like, yee, that's so exciting that we both speak in spreadsheets. It's great. Delia, thanks for coming. Angela, so glad you're here. Ayana, you're here. I'm so glad. And again, anybody who is saying hi or putting comments in the comment section, put your name in so I can tell who's joining us, because from StreamYard, I can't see your name. So I'm so glad you're with us. So we want to talk today. I want to talk today about Hallie and get her perspective on the whole world of VAs. Mm-hmm. And solopreneurs, the first thing I'm trying to get all of y'all to do is to start getting stuff off your desk. This is one of the common themes that I'm talking about. And the resistance that many solopreneurs have is, I can't afford it, I don't want to train anybody, you know, yada, yada, yada. And my hue and cry is always, just get started. You can hire a VA for 5 hours a week, 5 hours a month, and something small to get used to the idea that you are getting something off your desk. And once you find a goddess like Hallie, you'll start finding that it gets easier and easier. And it's easier to say, yes, I don't want to do that. Yes, someone else can do this better. Yes, you know, I was paying for 5 hours. Now I'm happy to pay for 10. So just get started And you'll find that this just ramps up your ability to go from solopreneur to CEO exponentially. So Hallie, let's get started. Why don't you tell us what a VA is?
Okay. Well, that's a big question people say. What is a VA? What is a virtual assistant? VA means virtual assistant. So for some of you that weren't even sure what that means. So it's basically someone that assists you in the day-to-day operations of your business, but they do it virtually from their own home or their own office. So they don't have to be sitting right next to you. This idea has been growing over the years, but I think after the pandemic, I think people even more open to it because we all had to figure out how to work remotely and not next to each other. So people got more comfortable with the idea of, okay, we can make this work if you're not sitting across from me or in the same office. I don't need to see you 8 hours a day in order to work alongside you. So I think people are getting more and more comfortable with the idea of a VA, but there's someone that can be your sidekick or your go-to person that can take things off your plate that you don't really enjoy doing or you don't have the time to do or is not appropriate for you to be doing at the CEO level.
Yep. Thank you for saying that. Yeah. One of the things that I discovered, I've used VAs for the past 10 years. And one thing that I've discovered is that there are things that I'm crap at doing. I mean, I'm not a detail person and things fall through the cracks. I'm perfectly willing to admit that I just don't dot my I's and cross my T's. The other thing is there are things I don't do well, and then there are things I don't like to do, don't like it. I have the ability, and that's one of those rabbit holes, you know, where you know you can do it, and therefore I should be doing it. And again, we have to give ourselves permission to say, I don't want to do this anymore. Right. So this is where once you find a good VA, they will do it better than you can, and they will free your mind up so that you can get those I don't like it things off your desk and they can take it over. So Hallie, what are some of the kinds of things that a VA will do?
Well, there's a variety of things that a VA can do. They can do something as simple as manage your calendar. So I know that in this world of I want to book an appointment with you or let's get together, the back and forth of that can be create. How time consuming is it to just book an appointment with someone, right? What's available here? What's available here? So a VA can either set up a system for you or they can manage your calendar for you and make sure that you're not overbooked. They can do travel arrangements when that starts to be appropriate again. There's a whole host of bookkeeping things that a lot of VAs specialize in. Mm. So whether it's just managing your books to begin with, I mean, just setting up QuickBooks or whatever software you use, managing paying your bills, reconciling your bank accounts, like that makes me want to, that's not obviously not my specialty. but there's a whole bookkeeping side to it. And some VAs might, if they're specialized in bookkeeping and they're certified bookkeepers, they can even do some minor tax things for you, like filing for your quarterly tax payments, you know, just dealing with all of that banking and bookkeeping stuff. Some VAs specialize in marketing like myself. So if it's email campaigns or social media, managing your Facebook groups like we're doing here, just doing blog writing. Some VAs specialize in content writing. Some don't, but they can help you work with a content writer if they don't do that. There's also just, I had a client one time that I just booked appointments for them. So they didn't have the time to just do some like touch base calls and set up appointments. So I had access to their calendar. I did that. Those kind of things. There's a rainbow of things that a VA could do, but those are some of the overall things that you see on a regular basis: bookkeeping, marketing, and calendar management, and just some admin tasks in general.
And I think one of the things that you and I are discovering the more we work together is that you certainly have just a huge wealth of capability. And frequently, I'll just have to say, "Can you do?" or "I'm having trouble with this," and you'll be able to say, "I got it," or "If I don't know the answer, I'll find it out for you," or "Here, I'll take it over for you again." And I wouldn't know that going in, but the sooner the more you work with someone that you really work well with, you can start to figure out where else you can go with the relationship. It's really fantastic.
Yeah, it is.
So I'm happy about that. When do you know it's time to get a VA? This is where I say hair on fire, you know, you just don't know how you're going to survive. When do you know it's time to get a VA?
Well, I like to not wait until you know it's time. So you know it's time when you're in pain. So I would like to recommend you not wait until you're in pain. Yeah. Plan it ahead of time. So if you think of all the departments you have in an organization, you have your sales and marketing, you have your actual client fulfillment, you know, servicing, whether, you know, actually doing the work. There's, you know, strategy and, you know, vision, what's coming next. And then there's the whole admin side. So when you think of all those things that you wear the hat of as a solopreneur, peel off the parts that are easier for you to do ahead of time. So my recommendation would be to start with even 10 hours a month or 5 hours a week, whatever, and peel those off quite right before you're in pain. But you know it's time for a VA when you just can't keep up, when you start, it's starting to affect your sleep, your focus, you're starting to get irritated about having to do a project and you're procrastinating. Those are all signs that it's time to let go. Mm-hmm. Or if you are using that item as an excuse to build your business to the next level, that's also a sign it's time to let go. Like, I can't grow my business because I'm too busy doing social media or because I have to catch up on my bookkeeping. Yeah. If those pop in as excuses in your head, it's time for you to start looking into getting a VA.
You know, that's what I found when I hired my first VA was I couldn't take any more business on. Mm-hmm. I was just maxed. And, you know, when I started playing that back, I thought that is a ridiculous place to be. I mean, how can you say no to business? But I really, truly was too busy. And mm-hmm. it made me rethink, you know, why am I too busy? What am I doing? Mm-hmm. You know, what am I doing that I can be getting someone else to help me with? So, but I like that of doing that before you're in pain. I think that's fantastic.
Because then you think it takes me so long to train them or to turn this over to someone, I might as well do it myself. So if you find yourself getting in that habit, it's hard to get out of that. So try to do it before that happens. And I also want to encourage you to let go of things that you actually like doing, but it's better suited for a VA. People love doing their social media, but how much time does that take versus what you could do to serve another client? So even if it's something you love, but it's more appropriate for you to delegate that once you have a nice system going, that's also another sign.
Yeah, that's a good thing to think about because I was asked by one of the gals on my last Facebook Live said, you know, but I like doing, I think it was the social media. Why would you tell me not to? And I thought, because it's not money generating. You know, your job as a CEO is to get the money coming in, not that other stuff. So
it doesn't mean you lose your voice in social media because you can do that cooperatively with your VA. You know, so you can still use your voice and give them some ideas for content and whatnot. But once they get to know you well enough, they'll know how to match your brand.
Totally. I mean, that's the thing that totally surprised me is that not surprising with you, but the degree to which once someone gets to know you, your style, what the group feels like, what your copy feels like, they can emulate and it doesn't feel canned or inauthentic at all. So, and the more you get to know your VA and you get to work well with them, the better it is for everybody. Mm-hmm. So the other question, Ayana, you might be thinking about this because you said you're thinking of hiring one. How do you find a good VA?
Well, this is the question of the hour, right? So I need this a VA. Where do I find one? Where do I even start? The highest effective way is to ask your network of people. So you can post in any of the groups that you're in. I know in your group here, you have a couple of VAs in here. So it's a place, even just posting it in a group like this, who offers VA services, I forget, I'm looking for blah, blah, blah. So make sure they know what it is you're looking. Are they looking for bookkeeping? Or are they looking for marketing? Are they looking more for an admin assistant type role? So, you know, posting it in social media, posting it on your own Facebook page, who knows a good VA? I'm looking for one. Word of mouth is the most effective way to get a VA because you know they've worked with someone and they can come highly recommended. There's also a Facebook group, and I wrote it down here, The Virtual Savvy. I used to be in it a while ago, but it was too, you know how sometimes your feed fills up with too much stuff. So I got out of it for a little bit. But when I first became a VA, this was a wonderful group for me. So it serves both the VA community and people looking for VAs. It's The Virtual Savvy. And she has a course to help VAs learn their skills. But there's also, if you need a VA, you can post in there what you want. And there's thousands of VAs in there. And then you can sort through and do an interview process and find which one works best for you. Right. There's also plenty of websites on which was my third option, and places like Upwork, and there's others very similar to Upwork. They're more transactional. And not to say that you can't find a great VA through Upwork, because I've heard of a lot of success through that as well. You just want to make sure you have a nice interview process and get lots of references for them. Right. So ask word of mouth. You can go in Facebook groups, Virtual Savvy, or even some of the communities that you're already in and ask for referrals. And then third, you can go online, look at places like Upwork, and you can put in a bid for what you want. And I mean, a request for what you want. And some people send you bids back and you can interview and do your due diligence that way.
Hallie, do you think it's important to have someone in the same time zone or in the same country, or what are your thoughts on that?
If your work is time sensitive, absolutely. If it's, I need this done, but you can do it at any time of the day, then time zone, you know, could be a little bit flex. I think it's hard if someone's completely on opposite, like when you're the whole time you're sleeping, the whole time they're awake, unless it's a marketing project that really they can write, do whenever, but you have to consider ongoing communication with them. And if that's always going to be an issue, that's going to get frustrating, you know, even to have a 15 minute call if that's a big deal. I would definitely consider that.
You're on the East Coast, I'm on the West Coast. That's been a non-issue for us. But I know that I've had VAs that were in the Philippines who did excellent work, but there was this complete disconnect. Mm-hmm. So when they were asleep, I was awake and vice versa. And it just made communication really challenging and more challenge than I wanted to deal with at that
right.
point.
Right. I mean, really. In theory, it sounds good, but you have to communicate a lot more. You bounce back and forth a lot throughout a day.
Yeah.
Unless it's like a one-off project where even then it can be kind of difficult.
Right. I think also what I wanted to add to that is I would say every resource that I have, I found through my own network. You know, mm-hmm. I'm a part of several entrepreneur groups, big ones. And I'll just, what you said, put out there, I'm looking for whatever. I need advice on the best software program for fill in the blank. And people who know you are going to make recommendations that are personal, and it always leads to the best results as opposed to going online and just doing a search. So I would agree with that. You guys, if you have any questions for Hallie, put them in the chat. And let me just go through the questions that Hallie and I scoped out ourselves, and then we'll circle back and see how we can answer your questions. So don't hesitate to put them in the chat area. How about payment? What do you typically pay a VA?
That is, you know, I hate the answer to that. How much weight can you lose on this program? Well, that depends. How much do you pay a VA? Well, that depends. It really, really does depend on what you're asking for. If you're asking for some high level organized bookkeeping, you're going to pay a little bit more than if you're asking for calendar management. Right. So I would say a VA would start in the range of $25 an hour. Right. And it can go, you know, 40 to 50 is normal. If you're going to be you're going to be paying someone to do a copywriting project or website content writing, that might be a little higher in the $75 an hour, but that's more project basis, not a regular basis. So there is going to be a range. If you go to places like Upwork and those platforms, you're going to get a lower cost. You might have higher turnover though. So, you know, you want to balance those two things. So anywhere in that range, pay very, very close attention to contracts, because VAs, if they're a reputable official VA, they should have a contract if you're doing ongoing work like that, where it spells out their privacy, how they're housing your information. An agency, they should have that. And it'll talk to you about payments and how long they'll work for you. You know, like if it goes above this, you know, you buy a time block. Some of them will have you buy a block of time and you have 6 months to use it. Some of you can be some of them offer a monthly retainer, and they just go above or below 10% a certain number of hours. So you pay a retainer for 20 hours a month, but it can go 15 to 25 hours and it's the same no matter what. And then how do they bill you? Do they bill you monthly, weekly? So these are things that you would want to talk about with your VA as far as payment. For, you know, projects, I like project basis, you know, projects, because it's usually a flat fee because VAs have an idea how long things take. So you're not having to time track every 5 minutes you're working on a project. So those are things to keep in mind as you're looking at payment, the skill of what you're asking, their experience, and then how is payment going to be collected?
I think just to flesh that out a little bit, the people who are less experienced will charge you less. Their quality or their capability might also be less. And, you know, you sort of have to know going in what level of quality you want to get back out.
Right.
The other thing is, it's a really good idea to really have a good idea of what you're asking, what your needs are going in, so that if you know you need, hey, Yvonne, I'm so glad you're here. If you know you need areas, bookkeeping, if you know you need copy help, if you need just admin stuff, you know, this is sort of the garbage in, garbage out mentality, right? Where you, if you know well what you are going to ask for, then right, you can do a better job finding that person and negotiating with them. Another thing that I like to do with a VA is start them on a specific project.
Yeah.
One project that's 1 week long or 1 month long, it has a beginning, a middle, and an end, and there's a deliverable, because you're testing each other, you know, and you want to test how good are the communications, how well are they following through on your requests? Do you get along? You know, do you, you don't want to make a long-term investment emotionally or financially in someone until you tested the waters. So my advice is always to start with a particular project and then see how that goes and let them know, you know, this is going to be a 30-day project. We're going to do this together. We'll see how things go, and not even commit to life after the project. But you have to be sure that you're getting along with someone and working really well with someone before you make that kind of a commitment to go forward.
Absolutely. And in some VAs will want you to buy a block of time right up front, and they might discount it, as opposed to you can pay hourly. A block or a retainer is usually how it goes, right? Mm-hmm. You'll get a better bargain if you are on retainer than you will a block of time than you will hourly. But I always started my new clients that I didn't really know well at hourly. So let's just work together for a couple weeks on an hourly basis. And if we like it, then we can move you into a block of time. And then if it works really well, we'll move you into a retainer.
Yeah.
So we didn't want to lock anybody in to anything that I had to, what if it wasn't a good fit for the VA either? You know, sometimes, you know, it's on both sides.
Right.
Of that. So that's what I would recommend. Trust is huge when you're dealing with a VA, and that's a hard thing to build when you're remote. You've never met them. So I definitely agree with starting them out with a smaller project or something short term, so you can get a feel for how you guys work together.
And the other thing that comes with the doing is, and we'll talk about this in a second, is the communication.
Mm-hmm.
I have found that you figure out better and better communication as you go.
Yeah.
You know, what, not just how you phrase things, but how often do you want to communicate? Do you want to have a formal weekly brain dump? Do you want, you know, you figure that stuff out as you go, but each person has to be willing and able to be upfront and communicative about what their needs are so that it can be a mutually beneficial relationship.
Yeah. Well, I want to talk a little bit about communication because training and communication and managing the whole, if you being managed as a VA or managing your VA, those are big topics. The finding when it's time, how to find them, how to hire them, that seems like the daunting part, but actually once you're in a relationship with them, the ongoing relationship can be where it trips you up. So are you on the same page with communicating? So the more you can talk about this upfront as you're entering into your relationship, the better. So I get crystal clear on what I'm doing and when it's due by. So what is your expectation of when this is due, you know, on an ongoing basis, so that I make sure that I'm meeting that deadline. And if it's vague, then it leads open, you know, to just
misinterpretation
from both sides, because you're upset it's not done, but they were like, but I didn't know when it was done. So that's both responsibilities to make sure that's clear on an ongoing basis. So if you just have, you know, if there's set things you have them do on and on, you know, a weekly touch base is a great idea. So let's touch base Monday morning or Friday afternoon, whatever works for you guys. Or sometimes it's midweek that works best. So I would recommend you have a touch base 15-minute call, especially as you're getting going, to see how things are going along. If it's a more complex project, you're going to want to have something like Trello or Asana or a work, a software that's online that helps you manage the projects that you both have access to. Mm-hmm. Because you can put in there what they need to do on a daily, weekly, recurring basis. You can put instructions in there on how it's supposed to go. If there's certain phrasing or things that details they need to know about a certain client, that can be put in there if they're doing any client-facing work. And then they can put notes in there too. Mm-hmm. This is what I did. I called them, left a message. So if they're responsible for a calendar management and you want them to make an appointment with somebody and the appointment hasn't been made, you can just go look there real quick to see, well, what's going on? She's called them three times. They haven't answered back, and emailed twice, you know, so you get a really good sense of what their cadence of their work is. Mm-hmm. So I highly recommend those. You know, Trello is a really hot one right now. Asana is more complex, but the people that get in and set up Asana love it. So you'll find the one that works for you. Yeah. And then both people can make comments, and you can message each other through Asana as well. So, you know, a touch-based meeting once a week, preferably over Zoom. Even if you're not makeup ready, camera ready, it's okay. You're just touching base with each other. You don't have to look perfect, but it's good to get that eye contact going as much as you can with your VA to establish that kind of relationship. And then managing the projects through like a third party type thing so that you can both communicate well on it. Mm-hmm. Some people also do Voxer or Slack or WhatsApp, they use to communicate on projects as well. So in Voxer, it's kind of like, feels like a walkie-talkie where you talk to each other immediately. So as opposed to texting or emailing or whatever, you might find a piece of technology that works best for you for these quick messages. So depending on the complexity of your project and what you have doing, that is the best way to communicate and slash manage what's going on with your VA.
So, Hallie, in your opinion, what makes for a good boss, a good client, you know, a good client?
I'm glad you brought this up because this wasn't in our talking points, but yeah. I've been thinking a lot about it. But it's tricky being a VA, and I'm going to speak from a VA's point of view. Mm-hmm. So I get hired as a VA. We agree to our scope of service. You want to have a lot of communication up front, but not the feeling of distrust. So if I have a client that's like, why did that take you a half hour? It should have taken you 15 minutes. Or, you know, you didn't track time yesterday. You know, like the micromanaging, the feeling like they're not trusted yet is a very uncomfortable place for a VA to be. So I have learned over the years, though, that I that's just a sign that they're having trouble letting go. But if you're not in that awareness, you just get defensive and feel like, what am I doing wrong? Or they're too controlling, or you put a negative light on it. So I try to have the conversation of, are you having trouble letting go? Or is there something I could be doing to earn your trust better? But that not every VA is going to be touchy-feely like I am with that, you know?
Mm-hmm. Like, and that's forthcoming.
What's at the bottom of this mood that they're in? Like, is it something I'm doing, or is it just hard for them to let go? Mm-hmm. And so I think what makes a good boss is someone that gives you clear instruction, clear like deadlines and expectations, communicates freely with you. There's nothing more frustrating than doing work and not being able to get in touch with the person you're working for, because it happens on the other end too. And just being open when they're struggling, letting go with the delegating. It's really hard. It's not easy to let go of your baby and trust that someone else is going to take care of it as much as you would. So I feel like those conversations, you need to be honest about them up front and anticipate that those will happen as an entrepreneur, and kind of even talk to your VA. Like, I'm having trouble letting go of social media because I love it and it's my voice. So let's figure out what I can do to get comfortable as you take this over.
Mm-hmm. That takes, Hallie, that takes a level of maturity that not all VAs come to the table with.
Right.
And not all clients come to the table with.
Right.
So being able to, you know, recognize and admit what you don't know or what you're not doing well, or that's a lot.
I know. Well, maybe just bringing it up here as the entrepreneur, now you're in awareness. So as you enter in a relationship with the VA, it's something you could talk about, you know, talk about it up front.
Well, you were so cute when I was interviewing you, and I interviewed three or four people, I think, before I brought you on. One of the things you said was, how did you phrase it? Something to indicate that you had opinions and you wanted to be listened to. Are you one of those people who's willing to listen to an outside voice? You go, girl. That is great. I can't remember.
Well, it's a partnership. I think it was more of like, I want to work alongside of somebody. Yeah. I don't want to be just, don't just give me tasks and I do them. I like to, you know, like, let's look beyond that. What happened before it that could make it better? And what could we do different next time?
Yeah.
Not every VA is going to be like that. And you might not want a VA for that. So, mm-hmm. you know, you, if you have a VA that's me and likes to be involved in the process, that I might not be a good fit for you, because you just yeah. do A through Z, do it and mark your time and leave me alone. Yeah.
I can't imagine not wanting that. I mean, I'm the first one to admit that I don't have all the solutions, or even 90% of the solutions, to have someone else come in with ideas. And, mm-hmm. you know, that's just a godsend. That's fantastic. And so
usually VAs get you organized like you didn't even see possible. You know, there's a way to mm-hmm. organize things that you, we've seen from all our work with other clients that will, might work in your, whether it's just files or your calendar management or a software you didn't know about. And, you know, so there's a lot that that an experienced VA can bring to the table, because they've just seen so many different ways of doing things that they might shed light on your processes or your systems that you didn't know.
Right. And the other area where I've found you've been extremely helpful is tech support. Even though we never talked about tech support going in, you know, I would run into a problem where I didn't know how to do blah, blah on an application that I was using. And I could say, you know, is there a solution to this?
Right.
And you'd be able to zoom in and say, either I can do it for you, or yes, there is a solution, go here and find it. Where,
right.
Because you'll be more aware of the options than I would be.
Right. Right. And as a VA, one of our jobs is to figure it out. And I have a little sticky over here on my desk that says, I will figure it out. Because now that I'm in my 50s, you know, sometimes I get a new thing and I'm like, oh, am I too old for this? But I'm like, I will figure it out. So that's our job, to figure it out for you. You don't need to be the expert on everything, about everything that it takes to run a business. That's what you get your VA for. And there's a certain level of expectation that we know how to do some basic things. And if we have to figure out a new software or whatnot, I just figure it out. I don't charge for that time, because it is expected that I would know how to upload an email into Constant Contact. So if I've never worked in Constant Contact, that's not your problem. I should be able to figure that out within 10 or 15 minutes. So,
and you're going to be able to apply that to another client as well.
Correct.
So,
a good VA should be your person that can figure it out for you within a reasonable amount of time.
Yeah.
Or say, this isn't going to work, we need to, you know, get an IT person, or, you know, go to the next level. So, yeah.
Right. Yeah. Guys, what questions do you have for Hallie? She's here and wide open. So don't be shy. Drop a question in and we will, I will ask her. She will. Hallie, can you see the chat?
I cannot.
Okay. So if you guys drop in a question or a comment, I'll just let Hallie know what it is. I have found, as I said earlier, that a couple things that are really important, starting with a project so you test mm-hmm. each other out.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, so that you test out, I'm speaking from the client standpoint,
yeah.
you test out your own chops at being able to be communicative, to give direction clearly. You know, we all think we're being clear, but sometimes that's not the case. So you get to check out your own capability. Being able to evolve your own communication with your VA and vice versa, because you don't hit the ground running. You know, you have to figure stuff out as you go. You have to figure out each other's styles mm-hmm. as you go. So it takes a while to really get humming. And I've also had VAs that just didn't work for whatever reason, you know, mm-hmm. and so that, and I'm sure you've had clients that didn't work. We were mm-hmm. talking about this before we came online. Have you found that you've had people that you just had to say, you know, this has been lovely, but not fitting?
Yep. I have. It's so hard. But they just aren't a good match for, you know, they'll buy a block of time and they won't hear from for 6 months, and then they want something in 10 hours. So, you know, sometimes yeah. that's fine. And sometimes that doesn't work with your schedule. And if that happens a lot, maybe that's not the right fit for you. If you have, you know, if your week is booked, and you just have to gently bring them to that, and it's okay. I think going into it, knowing that it's okay if this doesn't work out, I think that's a good, sorry, that's my computer.
I can't
silence the ding when I'm on my I'm on mic here. I should have done it before. Sorry. So I think just knowing that, like you said, starting out small and saying, we're going to try this out and see how this works
mm-hmm.
so that everybody knows that's where you're coming from. So that if it doesn't work out, it's okay. It's mm-hmm. totally okay if it doesn't work out. Not everybody's a good fit for each other.
Right. Hallie, do you have anything else to, I'm not saying any questions, you guys. So
okay.
I'm just going to say, Hallie, do you have anything else you want to add? Well, I know what I want to say. Mm-hmm. You guys can contact Hallie through the group and in DMs, but Do you want to talk? How else can they get a hold of you? Where can they hire you if they want to hire you? What's the contact information
for I left my agency when I started doing live lunch support through for you, that clientele. So I got so busy so fast, I didn't build a website yet. I have to get to that somehow. But yeah, anyway, right. I have a Facebook page. It's at Virtual Matters by Hallie. Or you can message me here in the group. And I'm happy to help you answer any questions you have.
That's great.
As you go down this journey of hiring a VA, whether it's me, whether it's, I help you. If I have a VA that I know of that I've worked with that I can recommend for you, I'm happy to do that. If it's not in my wheelhouse, if you're dealing with something where you're like, am I crazy or are they crazy? Bounce it off me and I'll help you out there too.
That's great.
I promise you, you will be so glad when you get help in even planning it ahead. Even if it's 6 months, in 6 months from now, I know I'm going to take this off my plate and give it to a VA. Just knowing that, you know, that's your plan. And then you can start doing the research now of the places you can look. It's never too early to start planning that and having, writing down all your processes so that they're clear on how you like things done. So when they pick it up, they're not guessing. Yeah. So even if you're not ready for one, spending some time writing down the things that you do that you want to give over to them with the systems of how you like to have it done so that it's easy to give to them.
Totally.
So that would
be even if you're not financially ready yet, getting ready with the systems per se. So you can say, this is how I get an email newsletter out. This is how I do, you know, whatever it is.
Right.
And then then you're all set to go when you're bringing someone in.
Right. And then as you train them, if for some reason that doesn't work or they have to shift their focus and you have to hire another, you already have those processes laid out. Yeah. So the downtime and the ramp up time isn't as big if you have processes written down.
Right. So. Great. Hallie, thank you. Anything else you want to offer or add? No one's asked any questions, so you must have answered all our questions. Nothing else?
Okay. I guess we just answered all of it ahead of time.
I guess. Yeah. So, Hallie, thank you so much for joining me today.
You're so welcome.
A couple more things that I want to say to everybody here. If you haven't signed up for the next Solo2CEO Launchpad, please do. When I file this video, I'll put the link above. I'm also taking 3 or 4... strategy sessions in the next 2 weeks. I have some open time, would love to help you guys with anything you want to talk with me about. These are 20, 30 minutes just so I can get you to the next step, just so I can help get you up and running. So I want to make sure that you, as I said yesterday in my coaching call, you can't move a parked car. So I just want to be able to help you get that car in motion, get your business in motion so we can get you to the next step. So I'm available for those calls. I'll put the link to that up in the the section above the video as well. So that's it for us. That was 37 minutes. Good deal. Hallie, thanks so much for your time. I really appreciate it. And thanks everybody for joining us today. I'm so glad you were here. Take care, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.